10 events that happened on May 20th. 1. On 1498, Vasco da Gama, a Portuguese explorer, achieved a milestone in global exploration by becoming the first European to reach India via sea, landing at the port of Calicut, present-day Kozhikode. His successful voyage around Africa's Cape of Good Hope signified a groundbreaking moment in the age of discovery, providing Europe with a direct sea route to the lucrative spice markets of the Indian subcontinent. Da Gama's arrival in India not only transformed global trade patterns but also laid the foundation for Portuguese imperialism in Asia, marking a pivotal moment in world history. 2. On 1873, Levi Strauss and Jacob Davis, two immigrants, made fashion history by securing a US patent for a new kind of work pants reinforced with copper rivets, a design we recognize today as blue jeans. This innovative addition of rivets to the stress points of men's work pants dramatically increased their durability, creating a garment that was perfectly suited to the needs of workers in the American West. The granting of this patent not only marked the birth of the blue jean, but it also laid the foundation for Levi Strauss & Company, a company that would become synonymous with denim and a ubiquitous part of global fashion culture. 3. On 1882, a significant pact was formed in the realm of European diplomacy, the Triple Alliance between the German Empire, Austro-Hungary, and the Kingdom of Italy. This agreement aimed to establish a mutual support system among the three nations, promising aid to each other in the event of an attack by any other great power, marking a significant shift in European power dynamics. The formation of the Triple Alliance had far-reaching implications, creating an intricate web of alliances and counter-alliances that shaped European politics and eventually played a role in the outbreak of World War I. 4. On 1902, Cuba made a significant stride in its national history by gaining independence from the United States, a momentous occasion for the Caribbean island nation. The end of U.S. rule marked the culmination of Cuba's long-fought struggle for self-determination, which had begun with the fight for independence from Spain before the Spanish-American War. The United States had assumed control of Cuba following Spain's defeat in the war, initially administering it as a protectorate during a period known as the American military government or U.S. occupation. The transition to Cuban control was symbolized by the installation of Tomás Estrada Palma, a Cuban revolutionary and political figure, as the country's first president. The inauguration of Estrada Palma marked the start of Cuba's self-governance and the beginning of a new chapter in its political and social history, even as U.S. influence remained significant in the years to follow. 5. On 1908, James Stewart, who would become one of the most respected and beloved actors in Hollywood, was born in Indiana, Pennsylvania. Known for his distinctive drawl and everyman screen persona, Stewart's film career spanned over six decades, featuring roles in classics like It's a Wonderful Life, Rear Window, Vertigo, or Philadelphia Story. With an impressive list of awards and recognitions, including 5 Academy Award nominations and 2 wins, Stewart's influence in the film industry continues to be recognized long after his death in 1997. 6. On 1927, Charles Lindbergh, a daring young aviator, embarked on an unprecedented journey as he took off from Roosevelt Field in New York in the spirit of St. Louis, amidst skeptics doubting his ability to cross the Atlantic Ocean solo and nonstop. Navigating through challenging weather conditions and enduring extreme fatigue, Lindbergh successfully piloted his single-engine monoplane for over 33 hours, a testament to both his skill and the aircraft's design. Upon landing at Le Bourget Field in Paris, Lindbergh became an international hero, his extraordinary feat of completing the first solo non-stop transatlantic flight symbolizing the dawn of a new era in aviation. 7. On 1940, a grim chapter in human history began when the first prisoners arrived at Auschwitz, a new concentration and extermination camp established by the Nazi regime in occupied Poland. These prisoners were mostly Polish political dissidents, intellectuals, and resistance members, targeted by the Nazis for their opposition to the German occupation. As the Holocaust unfolded, Auschwitz evolved into a sprawling complex of death and forced labor, witnessing the harrowing horrors of mass extermination, forced labor, medical experiments, and untold cruelty. Auschwitz became emblematic of the systematic genocide perpetrated by the Nazis, where over a million Jews, along with Romani people, disabled individuals, and other groups deemed undesirable by the Nazi regime, lost their lives. The arrival of the first prisoners at Auschwitz marks a chillingly significant moment in the Holocaust, symbolizing the beginning of an operation of mass murder that would leave an indelible scar on human history. 8. On 1946, Cher, a figure who would become an iconic force in American music and culture, was born. Rising to fame as a part of the folk rock husband-wife duo Sonny and Cher, she later established herself as a successful solo artist, with her distinctive voice and sense of style carving out a unique space for her in the music industry. Not limited to singing and songwriting, Cher also demonstrated her talents in acting and producing, becoming a versatile figure in entertainment and an enduring symbol of individuality and female empowerment. 9. On 1960, the film La Dolce Vita, directed by the renowned Italian filmmaker Federico Fellini, was awarded the prestigious Palme d'Or at the Cannes International Film Festival. The film, known for its insightful exploration of Rome's post-war society, received critical acclaim for its inventive narrative structure, stylistic approach, and profound social commentary. One of the most iconic scenes in the film featured the Swedish actress Anita Ekberg, who achieved international fame as a result, bathing in the Trevi Fountain in Rome. This scene became a defining moment in the film, showcasing Fellini's imaginative storytelling and Ekberg's commanding screen presence. The Palme d'Or recognition for La Dolce Vita on this day marked a significant milestone in Fellini's career and a pivotal moment in the history of international cinema. 10. On 1961, the Freedom Riders, a group of American civil rights activists, were met with a violent mob upon their arrival in Montgomery, Alabama, in their quest to challenge racial segregation in public bus systems. This brutal assault, perpetrated largely by white supremacists while local law enforcement stood by, underscored the deep-seated resistance to desegregation in the South and the dangers activists faced in this fight. Despite the violence, the incident served to galvanize national and international attention, thereby elevating the struggle for civil rights and prompting further federal enforcement of desegregation laws. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like and notification buttons. Subscribing would greatly support me, and it's completely free. Also, feel free to leave your comments below.